Sister had to read it. What it said was where you would report to evacuation and take and what you would take along with you. You had one week or 2 weeks times to get rid of your property or house or whatever you had. So a lot of Japanese either had to sell the stuff or they had to throw away the stuff or they said they could store things into government places, and all the Japanese was able to store.
Was that necessary? Was that against the Constitution? Heck, it was. You know, everything was against the Constitution. Like, they can't do this to the American citizen here during that time, but they did. They got away with it, right?
My father would turn in his samurai sword, so he buried it, you know, in the garage. Because when the FBI came to search our house, they made sure nothing was there in Japanese. My mother had the Emperor Hirohito's picture. She burned that up and things like that. I mean, they didn't want to have anything that pertained to Japan, otherwise, you know, they would be picked up. So
that's why they had to report to the internment camp. Just in case the children got lost, they could trace them back to the fold. So whenever they were traveling, they had to wear these, all the children had to wear the tags here. Here you see a gathering of the luggages, making sure we were on the plane, and all these suitcases were taken to camp. This is what they could carry with them and what they were authorized to take. So of course, coming home, they got to bring these things home. Mm-hmm. But rather than throw them away, they donated to us, so we just kept this to show them the luggage boxes here. I remember this incident. The military standing guarded us, making sure we boarded the train, and escorted us to assembly center. They were run by the United States Army. They had a position over us. What would have happened if they told you you would have to go to camp and he'd leave the animals here? Would you go? Would you go if they took you along with you?
Probably.
No, they won't go. They forced us to go. We didn't have a choice. Would you believe that? I mean, we were here, born in the United States. Yeah. This happened way back in 1942, before you were ever born. Now, the first place they took us was called assembly centers. Assembly centers were either racetracks or fairground. Racetracks were horse racing, do their competition, and fairgrounds were where during the summertime the fairgrounds were either animals and horses and stuff.
The women had to do the washing and the laundry baskets here. And the shack. They look like the tar paper. And these are the rooms where the Japanese had to live in.
And we were there for Fresno for 4 months. After 4 months, it took us 4 days and 4 nights, and we ended up in Arkansas. You can see how the barracks are built with tar paper here. In Arizona, it got so hot, they had to make double roofing. Each family were assigned a table, where after you got your tray of food, you sat with your family. That way, you know, you knew where to sit. So this is the way each family was able to sit at a mess hall. It got so hot that Gila River, the Gila River in Poston was located on Indian Reservation. The Gila River, I guess Franklin Delano Roosevelt invited his wife to come visit Gila.
Yeah, okay.
Well,
picture number
that's on the